The whole design process at SpaceX, at least back in this, back in 2008, 2009, when they were really in startup mode, was significantly different from traditional aerospace. In fact, it was well known that people who would come from either NASA or traditional aerospace to SpaceX would suffer a certain amount of culture shock getting used to this startup method of operating. For example, requirements, I never once saw a requirements document when we were working at SpaceX developing the thermal protection system. Essentially, Elon wanted a heat shield for his Dragon capsule. It had to be able to do Earth returns, but he also wanted it capable of doing lunar returns. That was pretty much it. That was the requirement document. And so then we worked in what you might call a collaborative design environment to come up with the heat shield that was compatible with the structure, with the propulsion system, with avionics and the other subsystems to give a successful Dragon capsule. So there's no formal, at least at that time, there was no formal requirements document that you typically would see under a traditional aerospace approach, where we spend a lot of time putting together fairly detailed sets of requirements, particularly for all the different subsystems. I didn't see any of that. I didn't witness any of it. Now, from that period of time when they were really doing a lot of development to today, they have brought in more of a production approach. They have gone to more requirements, documents, and configuration control. But at the time, back in 2008, they were very much in startup mode.